Jesus Christ, prior to his ascension into heaven, entrusted his people, referred to as his lamb and sheep, to the care of the apostles. The apostles bore responsibility for the care of those who belonged to the Church of Christ. Nevertheless, as the flock of Jesus Christ, the faithful remained and, till this day, still remain his own people. In the first book of Peter, chapter 5, verse 2 to 4, the ministers of the church are called upon to shepherd the congregation as the flock of God. They fulfill their tasks with a view to the return of Jesus Christ, the chief shepherd. Till this day, under the authority and commission from our Lord Jesus Christ, the chief apostle, district apostles, district apostle helpers, apostles are all referred to as apostles, have the mandate to care for the flock of God, make decisions that concern their salvation, and to prepare them for the return of Christ. For this reason, the apostles make a personal resolution to serve Jesus Christ and his people, which calls for sacrifice. The apostles of our time spend long hours traveling on impassable roads and terrains, spend many days away from their loved ones, endure different weather patterns, and even risk their own lives just to spread the teaching of Jesus Christ. In the like manner, District Apostle Kububa Soko, who currently resides in Chipata in Eastern Province of Zambia, traveled over 500 kilometers to Lusaka by road and another 600 kilometers to Western Province this past weekend. The District Apostles in Tourage consisted of District Apostle Helpers Robert Nsamba and Arnold Muhango, Apostles Oscar Sibote Kalumiana and Donat Kalyangu, and all Western Province Apostles. On Thursday, 20th October 2022, the district apostle and his entourage arrived in Lukulu. With love and hearts full of joy, the members who gathered in numbers to welcome the apostles could not hide their joy.
We want to follow you. We want to follow you again now and then. You and the leaders. We want to enter Jerusalem. Even the temptation is there to the Laodicea, forgive us. We want to enter Jerusalem. Thank you.
Friday, 21st October 2022, District Apostle Kububa Soko began his visit to Lukulu with a divine service at Libala Congregation.
And now the word. From the book of 1 Peter, chapter 2, verse 2. As newborn babies, desire the pure milk of the word, that you may grow thereby.
With yet another divine service to be conducted the following day on Saturday, 22nd October, the district apostle and his entourage covered approximately 80 kilometers through the plains of Lukulu to Mongu. 80 kilometers in a good road sound manageable. However, in these plains, one has to drive for close to 4 hours through the sand of the plains, a not so easy task to achieve. After the long and tiresome journey through the plains, the district apostle and his entourage then made a short stopover at Ikakuyu Congregation, where children of God shared a short fellowship with the apostles.
Ni wasoko wa Jerusalem.
Turej then proceeded to Mongu, which is about 30 kilometers from Ikakuyu congregation, where a concert was held at Maramba congregation around 19 hours. Saturday, 22nd October, an open-air divine service conducted by District Apostle Kububa Soko was held at Namangu Congregation in Sefula District of Western Province, where about 2,000 members attended this divine service.
And now the word for this divine service from the book of 1 Peter, chapter 2.
Among these members, some traveled and braved the hot weather and camped right at the congregation just to be part of the divine service. During this divine service, 9 district elders and 1 district evangelist were placed into retirement. The district apostle finally left Sefula to proceed to Kaoma, which is about 200 kilometers. Upon arrival around 17 hours, the district apostle graced a music choral concert at Luena Zambia Army Barracks Hall. The following day, Sunday, 23rd October, the district apostle and his entourage traveled to Nkema, which is about 40 kilometers from Kaoma, where he concluded his visit to Western Province with a third and final divine service at Munkuye congregation.
And now the word from the chief apostle. From the book of Romans, chapter 16, verse 19.
Six district ministers were placed into retirement during this divine service. Meanwhile, Western Province Minister Honorable Kapelwa Mbangweta, MP, in the company of other government officials, were also in attendance of this divine service.
Of course, with respect to the service this morning, it's very important in a lot of ways than one. For the district apostle to come to Nkema. You can see how important it is. There are so many people who have come here to see Mwendezi Ntuarash. And it's actually good what the church is doing, that the senior people can travel from the head office to come to the rural areas to visit the flock. It's very fulfilling.
According to the Catechism of the New Apostolic Church, Jesus Christ equipped the apostle ministry with extensive powers. They are ambassadors of Jesus Christ and act in his name. The characteristics and functions assigned to the apostle ministry have their source in the ministries of Christ. Thus, the apostles receive all the authority from Jesus Christ and exist in an unconditionally dependent relationship with him. It is evident that new apostolic church members heed to this call and mandate bestowed upon the apostolate. Nathaniel Loa, New Apostolic Church News, Western Province.